the 24 pictures Josef von Sternberg directed and the hundreds of players he filmed, none became more famous than this one, shot in Germany with Emil Jannings, The Blue Angel, or its star, Marlene Dietrich, whom von Sternberg discovered one evening leaning against the wings of a Berlin stage. He not only altered her life, she irrevocably changed his. The two commenced a notorious love affair and made another 6 movies together before going their separate ways, personally and professionally. At the time of their fateful meeting, von Sternberg was 36, at the height of a brilliant career in silent pictures, and talkies had just started. The director, who was also famous as a master of lighting, wrote at length of that momentous time in this acerbic and sardonic autobiography, misleadingly called Fun in a Chinese Laundry. Its author's original title was more to the point, considering his complicated and painful adventures in movie land. It was Guide to a Labyrinth. In 1928, von Sternberg's 5th feature, The Last Command, had been a critical and popular success, and its German star, Emil Jannings, had become the first person ever to win an Oscar, Best Actor, for this story of a commander in the Russian army who flees the revolution and ends up as an extra in Hollywood, co-starring William Powell and Evelyn Brent. And this was followed, later that same year, the last of the silent era, with The Docks of New York, a touching, poetically conveyed slice of life about a coal stoker and the desperate young woman he saves from attempted suicide, co-starring George Bancroft and Betty Compson. Just after seeing these two pictures, I mentioned once to von Sternberg how much I felt that both Evelyn Brent and Betty Compson resembled characters he was later to personify with Dietrich, and he barely let me finish before he said a bit testily, "That is ridiculous. Miss Dietrich is me. I am Miss Dietrich." When I repeated this years later to Marlena, she said it was true. "I just did what Mr. von Sternberg told me," she said, "and then I would come home and cook for him."
What am I paid for my apple? The truth that made Adam so wise.
Although Morocco was actually their second picture together, it was the first that Americans saw of von Sternberg's Dietrich in December 1930, 8 full months after The Blue Angel had begun to be a sensation in Europe. Gary Cooper and Adolph Manjou co-starred in this popular love story about a cafe singer who falls for a foreign legionnaire. The following month, in January 1931, The Blue Angel finally opened in America, and so in 2 pictures in 2 months, Marlene Dietrich had suddenly become the only rival to Garbo on the international screen. Not all the 7 von Sternberg-Dietrich pictures received such acclaim. In fact, the press became increasingly critical of their liaison, and their last 2 films were box office disasters, though perhaps their best. She once told me that when Paramount separated them and assigned her another director, every day, before each shot, she had the boom man lower the boom mic, and she spoke into it so the studio brass could hear when they saw the rushes. She said, "Oh, Joe, why hast thou forsaken me?" Only this other von Sternberg-Dietrich film is now available, Blonde Venus from 1932, their 5th together, a story of a mother's sacrifice and devotion, co-starring Herbert Marshall, Dickie Moore as her son, and a very young Cary Grant.
You so-and-so, you little so-and-so, look what you've done to me. You're almost twice as bad as who's this again? I ought to take you out.
After his last Dietrich picture in 1935, sad to say, von Sternberg only completed 7 more features in the 34 years he lived until his death in 1969 at age 75. Perhaps the best of these was The Shanghai Gesture, released in 1941, based on the shocking old stage melodrama by John Colton, starring Walter Huston, Gene Tierney in the Dietrich role, Ona Munson as Mother Ginsling, and introducing Victor Mature as Dr. Omar, as he says, Doctor of Nothing. But nothing in von Sternberg's work could ever compete with the extraordinary power of his greatest muse and creation. He referred to the Dietrich films of his as tributes. He wrote, "To the lady I had seen leaning against the wings of a Berlin stage."
Ça serait bien fin du fin si c'était le tour des enfants à mettre au monde les parents. Voyez-vous même ça ne m'énerverait pas. Moi je trouve tout très très bien.